Received a request if I could talk a little bit more about communication with spirits. There are in many religions, of course, texts which tell us that we should not. I want to go a little bit into the how and why of it. The problem if working with spirits is that spirits are often beings from nature or who have lived before. So they tend to be a little bit more conservative in nature rather than leading us forward or upward. On the other hand, because they have lived before, they're kind of like a dictionary or library, encyclopedia of all this knowledge of bygone ages, which can be a very important foundation for study and also building new theories and new spiritual practices on the basis of this foundation. So there's definitely also a value to it. One of the reasons why it is relatively ill-advised to work with spirits is that spirits are very similar to us. So there are beings which are very dissimilar to us, like you could say planetary spirits or solar angels. Gods, goddesses, angels. These beings are, you could say, on a very different plane of consciousness, have a very different existence, very different niche, very different goals. So they tend not to conflict with us, they tend not to compete with us. They are doing their thing, we are doing our thing, and there is a little contact and exchange of energy between us. But ultimately, we don't really matter that much to them. If I live or die has very little effect upon this planet, let alone upon the sun or other planets. And the same if I live or die, gods and goddesses have thousands, if not millions, of students or people they're educating, and in one form or other, the same power has different manifestations as different deities within different cultures, within different solar systems. So the I don't really matter. The deity or greater power will just do what they do, and I can in a way benefit from that. It is like sailing or surfing. There is a certain energy which is moving, there's a certain current. And you can use your sail to benefit and gain power from that current and be swept along with it or navigate it. With the smaller beings, this is not so much so. They are more like us, not so much they're not a current, but they're also paddling along trying to get somewhere, just like we are. And it is because of this reason that they are harder to work with, because this spirit will have their own agenda, and that agenda will be more on our level. So we can conflict with them more easily, we can compete with them more easily, and also because they're on our level, any use of force is considered to be kind of like fair and equal, and therefore allowed. Like a being on a much higher level of existence, like a solar angel or a deity, is so incredibly much more powerful in their energy body that it is removed and also disallowed from using all its energy in its competition with a being like me. It would be a little bit like stepping on an ant. And unfortunately, we are not forbidden from stepping on ants, but spiritually, these gigantic beings are forbidden from forcing their will on us. Because there would be no free will if there would be such a strong influence upon us. But spirits are more or less in the same category. We are, in a way, ourselves spirits. It's just that we have a body as well. And because this is such a fair arena or competition of wills, if you make contact with the spirit, you can get into these competitions and disagreements. And even if you have similar goals, you can have competitions and disagreements. Look a little bit at politics, for instance. Like, many people want to help their country, but they want to do it in very different ways. And yeah, they fight tooth and nail for the power to do so. And spirits do have a certain advantage over us who are incarnated. They have the ability to reshape energies much more easily than we can. So spirits are masters of illusion. If you make contact with the spirit, and it's very likely that it will appear as a being of light or an angel or something like this, regardless of its true nature. And the reason that they do so is that they can borrow authority. Like, people are very likely to obey a deity or obey an ascended master or obey an angel or a saint. So a spirit will often try to disguise itself as such a being so that it will gain power over the human it is communicating with. So if you're making contact with other worlds, and you should be aware of this power of illusion which the spirits have. And if a being appears to be an angel, a deity, a saint, or a spiritual master, it is quite all right to try to test that. So if it is appearing as a saint or an angel, well, ask it to pray, and then see if that prayer is indeed answered by the Holy Spirit or whatever it is that they're praying to, if it is from a non-Christian tradition. So this is a way to test if it is really what it seems to be. Same thing for every shape it takes. If it is appearing to be a spiritual master or something else, well then, ask it to do something which only such a spiritual master could do. And spirits can read minds, so no, that won't help. It can tell you everything about everybody. It can read your past, it can in part read your future, it can tell you about your thoughts and feelings. These are an open book to spirits, so this is not a real test. But often you will find that if it is truly such a power, then such a power has no problem with showing who it really is, with proving its authority. If, however, you're talking to a spirit in disguise, it will usually react with anger or frustration or become threatening and will tell you, like, how dare you question a servant of the Lord or something like this, and shame upon you. It will try to intimidate you and to bully you into not questioning it anymore, because ultimately it is afraid of being exposed. And true, an angel or a higher being is terrifying in its own right, very terrifying, but they don't get angry or they don't avoid any challenges you put before them. But of course it should be indeed a challenge. You can't cheat with that and try to get something done. Like, gosh, I always wanted to be rich. Well, if you're an angel, make me rich. Or something like this, because also a true angel won't react to that. It is serving the will of God, not your own will. So it is quite willing to prove itself or its nature to you, but it's not going to have the tables turned on it and become its servant just because you're pretending to be doubtful, or even if you are truly ignorant as to its nature. So always act with respect. Treat whatever you see as if it is that, but also form the habit of testing these beings which you make contact with. If you've tested the being and made contact with it several times, then you will learn to recognize it, maybe not the second or the third time you make contact with that being. But after that, you can be fairly sure that if you call it or if it manifests itself, that you can recognize it, just like you recognize a friend or a colleague or a pet. So, why would you then want to work with spirits instead of only with higher powers? Well, the advantage of working with spirits is that they have similar interests to you, which higher powers do not. So often for very limited goals. So for instance, if you want to be healthy, if you want to have advice with a very temporary matter, like for instance relationship advice, job advice, help with some problem, these are not of interest to spiritual powers. They only care about the advancement of your spirit. They don't care if you're happy with your relationship, if you're having a conflict with your boss, or petty little problems like that, which are connected only to the material world. And spirits are interested in that. They are willing to help you with that. So you could say that for the bigger spiritual issues on how to guide your spirits forward, contact the higher powers. For the smaller things, it is okay to contact spirits and to work on on that level. Spirits are also a wealth of information about local circumstances. So they can tell you what is going on in the forest or in the building or in an organization. Because it's very much their environment which they live in, they feel at home in. And you can often work together with spirits to improve such an environment, so it will be better for the spirits, but also better for other living beings such as humans who are living in such an environment. You can work together with creating changes in changing an environment which is filled with fear or anger into a more harmonious workplace. And again, these are matters which are of no interest to a greater being, but spirits often like their environments to be nice and filled with positive energies which are beneficial to them and also beneficial to living beings. Spirits are, you could say, the janitors of our world. So no, they're not the boss or the leader who has the big strategic plan on how to move the company forward or how to move humanity forward. But even such a great leader needs a janitor to clean the halls, to empty the waste bins, to fix the heating, so that the other people who are working for him can also function in a good way. So this is also, you could say, the spirit's responsibility to take care of the environment, to take care of the little problems. And different spirits have different goals, different responsibilities, and also different personal goals and